Well, hello everyone and welcome to the Horror Snob. My name is Michael James. I am the Horror Snob. Here today running down another top five forgotten favorites list, this time focusing on a particular subgenre within our world of horror, the horror western. Those movies that linger somewhere between the works of Wes Craven, Eli Roth, Lee Whannell, and that of something like Clint Eastwood's The Good, the Bad, the Ugly, Unforgiven. Now, speaking of Clint Eastwood, I know that there are several people out there that think that his unnamed character from the movie Pale Rider, that movie, that character, should be considered part of the world of horror. There is some idea that he is some sort of ghost, some specter, yada yada. I've seen the movies. I love the movies. I don't see it. I don't get it. I'm sorry. Those aren't horror. So for the purposes of our list today, you're not going to see Mr. Eastwood float on here at all. What you will see are five excellent films ranked bottom to top, 5-1, with number one being an absolute must watch, a film that I have seen at least once a year, every year since it has come out. Several of these have what we would consider an all-star cast, and starting off at number five today is no different. The movie that kicks us off, Dead Birds. Put out in 2004, the cast on screen features a group of people that are still relevant today. You're talking about dudes like Henry Thomas, who's been in the last couple seasons of The Haunting of on Netflix, The Haunting of Hill House, and The Haunting of Bly Manor. Then there's Mark Boone Jr., who spent several years on a bike for the Sons of Anarchy, the 7 years I think that show was on TV. Then there's a few award winners, guys who are regularly nominated for things and have taken home a few trophies over the years, Isaiah Washington and Michael Shannon. In 04, they might not have been names yet, but they were on their way. 16 years later, that cast proves to be one of the best of any of the movies in this subgenre. Hell, any movie in horror. How often do you ever see a cast like that in the realm of horror? A decent script that really feels like somebody's version of Evil Dead done mid-1860s. A group of Confederate soldiers plan a bank heist. They grab the gold and run for the hills and end up hiding out for the night in this abandoned mansion in the middle of a cornfield. As you can guess, things do not go well. Filled with ghosts, demons, rituals, cults, just about anything you can think of, this movie's got a bag of tricks up its sleeve with a reveal that pays off well right up until the last moments of the film. Not a perfect movie by any means, but definitely worth a watch. At number four, The Burrowers, a movie that doesn't quite have the all-star cast that Dead Birds did, but still some solid actors on screen, guys like William Mapother, who you'll know from Lost, and maybe most notably Clancy Brown, a dude you've probably seen in a dozen different things, including Starship Troopers, Shawshank Redemption, and most recently, The Mortuary Collection, a movie that released exclusively to Shudder right at the end of October. These two, along with a few other compatriots, go venturing out into the Wild West during the time of the late 1800s Plains Wars. Their mission? The search for a missing family, an entire family, that up and disappeared in the middle of the night. Gone with very little clue as to where or why, only that of the remains of one of the people in that household, who, let's just say, was not left in tip-top condition. Down the rabbit hole we go, and pretty soon we find ourselves face-to-face with some monsters not too much like anything else you have seen before. A good movie, done well, gorgeous scenery, and well-acted. This is easily another one like Dead Birds that can be overlooked, undervalued, and though, again, I wouldn't call it a perfect film, it is certainly a solid watch and one you might want to check out more than a few times in your life. And number three, it's Ravenous. Going all the way back to 1999, 21 years ago for this one, a longtime favorite, another one that's a must-watch almost year in, year out, and another one that's also an all-star cast kind of movie, with David Arquette, Guy Pearce, Robert Carlyle, Jeremy Davis, and Neil McDonough. And this movie's not just about the cast on screen. The story has a lot to love about it, from the way it just sort of subtly hints towards things that have actually happened in our history with the Donner Party, to the incorporation of Native American folklore with references to the Wendigo. All wrapped up in a very nice, neat little fictional story that is equal parts believable and unbelievable. A group of soldiers make their way through the frontier to an outpost that is on the outside edges of their territory to find that it is damn near abandoned, down to the very last man. Shortly after their arrival, they're approached by a man who makes wild claims about what he's seen. A Donner Party-like situation where people were eating one another to survive the cold depths of winter. Out into the forests they go to discover the truth behind his stories, and man, do things take a bad turn. If in somehow the 2 decades that have passed, you have not managed to watch this movie, I would be shocked. And if you haven't, this should be one of those top priorities on your list. An absolutely great movie that hits on so many different notes, it's hard not to love. And number 2, The Wind. A movie I've previously reviewed as a Fresh Frights selection going back about 2 months now. If you'd like to check out the full video for that, link is provided above. But the quick and easy down and dirty, cast-wise, you're really not going to recognize too many people, and that's because there's not too many people in this movie. It really focuses around 2 couples, 4 people, the lead in this, portrayed by Caitlin Gerard, somebody we as horror fans might recognize from things like the 4th Insidious movie, The Last Key, or 2012's Smiley. She and her husband living in houses way the hell out in the prairie in the middle of nowhere. Closest neighboring house is about 1 mile away, and it's empty until about the onset of this movie. New young couple moves in. New kids in town come over, have dinner. The 2 couples start to get close. Things get a little weird between them. All of this really portraying more like a Western drama than anything else. But behind it all, there is something seriously disturbed, demonic, that is toying with these people at their expense. Things progress worse and worse, and man, does this thing get dark. 1 part memento with all of the unraveling, the small clues that get laid out to us slowly over time. And 1 part The Witch, not for its pacing, mind you, as much as just the mood, the setting that's relayed to us as viewers, creating a great sense of loneliness, desperation, and darkness, just dreary, in a film that is very subtle, can easily be overlooked. If you have not seen it, again, I would highly recommend you take a moment. This is a near-perfect film for me, and one that I believe is a can't-miss. And finally, at number 1, Bone Tomahawk. The movie I warned you about right up front, an absolute must-watch film. Talking all-star cast, this thing is sick. Kurt Russell, Patrick Wilson, Sid Haig, Lily Simmons, David Arquette, Matthew Fox, and Richard Jenkins. I mean, who the hell else did you want in this film? This is as good of a cast as you will ever get in any horror film, regardless of the premise or the subgenre, and they play their parts perfectly. Even David Arquette, whose role in this film really isn't too dissimilar from the one he portrayed in Ravenous. Dude ended up on this list twice, if you weren't paying attention. If you have not seen this movie, this, out of all of them, obviously has to be the top priority. A movie that is easily equal parts horror and Western. About the first hour of this thing is really the Western part, involving Indians and cowboys and sheriffs and a small town that has an incident and then out goes a posse and yada yada. Doesn't sound interesting? I'm just poor at describing it. Trust me, it's a must watch. The last half hour is that payoff for the horrible description I just gave you. Because that last half hour is where you're going to see shit that is going to turn you white. God, I love that phrase from Ghostbusters. A great movie that pays off so well when we get to the climactic part, it's hard to imagine you had never heard of this movie prior to watching it. If you have seen it, I'd love to hear your comments on it. I think so highly of this film, and I haven't heard anybody say anything contradictory. And if you have not seen this film, of anything, this is the must watch. My top movie in the category of Western horror. All right, that's it for me today. As always, I invite you to take a moment, hit that subscribe button and the bell. Stay up to date with reviews, rankings, previews, everything I'm shooting out on a weekly basis. And while you're at it, take a moment to visit our partner merch store, Chaos and Havoc. Find everything you need, dark, twisted, crude, and humorous, for your holiday shopping needs, all at chaosandhavoc.com. My name's Michael James. I am the Horror Snob. I thank you for tuning in, and we'll see you next time.